Hi, good morning, Entrep. So, pinare-record ko na to. So, in case na hindi ako makapag-klase, at least na-i-discuss ko na siya today. So, yung topic for today is about value chain. So, value creation, necessarily processing, converting, improving, and adding value. So, basically, value adding ang tawag sa kanya. To give more appeal, utility, or value. So, from a raw material, ipaprocess mo siya and then so that you can create value doon sa product na yun from raw material. So service of value, kind of service rendered by the firm that is being paid for by the clients. And then value creation process, doing or rendering the service itself. So ito yung value chain system na I will discuss later on. So mamaya di-discuss natin to. The series of activities and process as well as the supply of raw materials or needed inputs involved in producing a product or delivering a service. So meron kayong from raw material up to papuntang customers. So supply chain, subject natin. So series of activities involved in the production or processing of a product or a service. So dinaanan lang natin yan. Supply chain management, so discuss na rin natin siya, total system approach to managing the entire flow of information, materials, and services from raw material suppliers through the factories and to the end consumer. And then distribution chain, ito yung mga involved doon sa supply chain. Okay, so parties involved in moving the products from the confines of perimeters of business producing the product. So value chain, process involved, so ito yung topic natin for today. Process involved in converting a product from raw material to its finished saleable and consumable stage. So process involved in converting a product, so yung value adding isang term dyan. Way of organizing the activities of a business so that each activity adds value or productivity to the total operation of the business, sum total of supply and distribution chain. So it covers all areas directly and indirectly involved in doing business value creation. So lahat ng mga in between from raw materials up to the end or to the end product to the consumer. So yung value chain is yung nasa in between. So paano nagawa or paano nag-come up, paano nataasan yung value ng raw materials and nung dumating sa consumer. So basically yun yung value chain. Center of activity, assembling the product or doing a series of activities to come up with the final product will be the opportunity for the firm to do its best. So during the process, doon na magagawa lahat ng processes. Kung kikita ba or hindi, ano ba yung may add na value from its raw material form. General components of value chain, meron kayong primary activities, operations in the business organization where most of the value creation efforts are made or done. And then you have your secondary activities, support activities that are undertaken to support the value creation activities, both at the level of supply and distribution chain or the entire value chain system. So in terms of primary activities, so ito yung mga involved sa primary activities. You have your inbound logistics, activities associated with raw materials or inputs, procurement activities covering vendor selection, comparative shopping, negotiating supply contracts, and just-in-time arrival of goods. They form part of the backward channel or supply side of the business. Okay, so next is operations activities involved to the actual conversion of raw materials into finished products. And then you have your outbound logistics activities equal to the inbound and processing activities, particularly such as aspect of storage, distribution, and shipping of the finished product. So when we say inbound logistics, ito yung pagbiyahe ng mga raw materials papunta sa inyong kung meron man kayong planta or sa inyong business location. And then operations, so ginagawa siya in outbound, ito yung ilalabas na yung mga product, yung mga gawa na, di ba? So inbound, process, outbound, kumbaga sa computer, di ba? And then you have your marketing and sales activity, deals with prospective clients including the ultimate customer or customer or end users. And then you have your services activity, focuses on after sale services to the consumer or to the customer, whether end user or processor or secondary producer. And then you have your secondary activities, So again, yung mga primary activities yun, yung inbound or yung input, process, output, di ba? So ito naman yung secondary activities, corporate infrastructure, the support backbone activities of the business operation, human resources, unique activity of matching the right people to the job expected, so division of labor, research and technology development, adds value in a way it improves the product and the business process and the primary activities. And then you have your backward channel, composed of the company's organization providing raw materials or other forms of inputs for the company, so mga suppliers. Forward channel naman, distribution side of the business or parties involved beyond the production and storage line. This group includes organization acting as distributors, dealers, agent, and etc. So yun yung forward channel. So backward channel, ito yung suppliers, and then forward channel, ito yung mga distributors. Revamping the value chain, abandon traditional business methods and shift to e-business technologies and use the internet. So when you say revamping, ay na-upgrade yung value chain. Use direct to end user sales marketing methods, simply product design, offer basic no-frills products or services or service. Shift to simpler and less capital intensive or more flexible technological process. So yung gaya ng sa Dell, 'di ba? Iba yung ginawa nilang process yung sa supply chain nila. So find ways to bypass use of high cost raw materials, relocate facilities closer to suppliers or customers, like yung ginawa ulit ng Dell, 'di ba? Lumapit sila dun sa mga suppliers nila. Drop something for everyone approach and focus on limited product or service and re-engineer core business processes. So basically, kung mag-i-stick kayo dun sa old way, yung ganito, na marami siyang dinadaanan, so that is not revamping your value chain. So yung recommendation dito is, or yung tip is, to revamp, to upgrade your value chain. So information system, okay, so e-commerce, allows the so-called seamless chain scenario, or one that electronically connects various organizations either in supply or distribution. Expediency and efficiency both in backward and forward channel of the business. So when we say e-commerce, ito na yung internet era. Okay? So dati kasi, it's merely letters, tapos ng cellphone, text and tawag lang. So ngayon, kaya na siyang gawin electronically. When it comes to logistics, inbound, outbound, so yung mga yan, di ba? So yun, isang way to revamp or to improve yung value chain. Internet technology benefits, powerful tool for better supply chain management, critical to internal operation, kasi though companies still have, and majority naman or lahat naman ng companies merong mga records, mga books. But using the internet or your computer can ease yung trabaho, yung workload ng inyong mga tao when looking for different data. Kung sa papel man yung nakasulat, di ba? So by using the computer or the internet, so mapapadali yan to the whole business. Okay, critical to internal operation, extremely useful for collaborative data sharing. So yan, gaya niyan, di ba? So rather than hahanapin yung papel, papadala dun sa supplier, and then yung supplier magsusort din. So ngayon, mas mabilis na. Send nyo lang yung e-copy, email, di ba? So makikita na, mag-re-reflect na yung mga transaction. Customer-oriented value chain, it takes the form of a circular model to emphasize the philosophy that the customer and not the business organization itself is the focus to which all the other activities are directed to. So when you create your value chain, or when you analyze your value chain, laging ang inyong goal or yung inyong objective is ano ba yung magiging outcome nito dun sa mga customer. Dibawa, ang dami-dami naming pinagdadaanan from raw materials, and then sobrang dami pang processes, and then marami pang pagdadaanan like dealer, distributor, retailer, reseller. So yung customer ngayon ang magsasuffer, di ba? So magmamahal yung presyo. So bakit hindi natin i-cut yung pwedeng i-cut doon para mas makatipid at same time mabibigay natin yung affordable and quality product sa customer. So yun daw lagi dapat ang thinking when it comes to customer-oriented value chain. Central to this kind of value chain model is that there exists an information system directly connecting the various functional unit, thereby allowing a scheme somehow assuring that the customer needs and wants are addressed by all functional units, and in a way, competitiveness is assured. So, ito yan. Laging yung customer, lagi yung nandun sa gitna, and lagi siya yung kinoconsider when it comes to giving value or giving the quality product to the customer. So, wag laging suggestion is yung value chain is concentrated dun sa customer kung ano yung magiging a brief and short explanation about value chain. So basically, value chain or creating value chain system is yung in between the raw materials and the customers. So backward channel, business organization, and then forward channel. So yung mga backward channel, ito yung mga nagdadala or yung mga suppliers. And then dadalhin yan dun sa inyong kumpanya. And then yung mga retailer, ito yung mga magpo-forward na papunta sa customer. Yung value chain system, ito yung kabuuan ng inyong process when it comes to giving or adding value sa raw materials. So yun lang naman siya. Okay, so yung other topics, i-upload ko na lang ulit para makahabol tayo dun sa mga time na na-miss. Okay, so thank you, God bless, and ipopost ko na lang yung attendance dun sa inyong classroom. Take care.